Hi, I'm Chad Haas from the Android team at Google, where I work on graphics and animations. And today I wanted to talk a little bit more about Listview Animations, which I talked about in a previous episode. This is another episode in the series that I like to call You're Doing It Wrong. So this is another item related to the last one where there is a need to understand how views are actually used by Listview. Listview recycles views, which means that when those views are not on the screen, it may use that view to hold different content. And you need to be aware of that, especially when you're running animations, so that you're not animating the wrong thing. So to demonstrate that, let's take a look at a little demo. So we have this demo that I call Listview Animations, and there's a long list and quite a boring one of cheeses. Now, as I click on these items, they're going to automatically fade out and then be removed from the adapter, and the list view is going to update itself, and that cheese will no longer exist. So we can scroll to someplace, we can delete this one, we can see the fade out, and then the list view collapses around it. So all of that is good. But what happens if we delete a couple of these and then fling the list? Hopefully you can see this on the screen, but what you should be able to see is, as I'm flinging the list, there seem to be items that have nothing to do with the ones that I clicked on that are being removed. And this is because we're running a fade animation on a view which has since been recycled and is being used for different content. Now, that doesn't mean that the wrong item is being deleted, but it does mean that the wrong view is being animated. So what happens is we click on an item, it starts running a fade animation on it, we fling the list, that view is off the screen, it gets reused for different content. The view continues fading because it's the same instance, it's the same object inside. So it continues fading even though it now shows different content. And then when that animation is done, then we automatically delete the original item. So the data is still intact, that's fine. But the visual experience on the screen is just weird, right? We don't want to do stuff like that. So there's a couple of ways that you can account for this, and I want to talk about those today. So for one thing, you could use this item called View Property Animator, and as of Jellybean, actually both of these ways of compensating for this are in the Jellybean release. One is to use View Property Animator, which internally tells this system, hey, I'm not done with this view yet, so just let me run my animation in peace. So if I'm using that for the animations, and then I do the fling operation, you'll see that there is no more disruption on the screen. Nothing is being faded out in the new views that we're seeing on the screen, because we are persisting the views that have the animations running on them. So basically we're grabbing it and saying, you know what, I have a lock on this view, don't recycle it yet because I'm in the middle of using it. If you don't want to use View Property Animator, another way to get the same capability, again in the Jellybean release, is to use this new property called Transient State. So you can call this method saying set has transient state, and that tells us you're in the middle of using it and we won't recycle it until you tell us to. So again, we delete some things, we fling the list, and we have no disruptive experience on the screen because we know that you're still using those views that you are fading out. So, interesting demo, more interesting code. Let's take a look at that. So we have this class called ListView Animations. We create the checkboxes and the list view and the adapter, all that stuff. The interesting part is down here. What happens when we click on an item? So when we click on it, we're immediately going to run this animation, but how we run it depends on which of those checkboxes we check at the top for using View Property Animator or Transient State or none of those. So in the none of those case, basically we lined up in this code down here. We say, okay, I'm going to create an object animator, and we're going to animate. In a previous episode, we saw some basics on how to use object animator. We use a target object, we use a target property, we're going to animate the alpha property on that view, and we're going to animate it to zero from whatever value it has right now, which happens to be one, fully opaque, usually is. So we create the animation, we set a duration of 1,000, way too long for this operation, but for the purposes of this demo, I wanted you to actually be able to see the animation and the artifact as it was happening. The transient state is not checked, so we're going to skip this code here, which is the interesting part, which we'll get to later. We're going to add a listener so that we can actually restore these things later and then remove it from the data set. So on animation ends, so when this nice little fade animation out to zero ends, we're going to go in here and actually remove it from the list of cheeses, notify the data set change, restore the alpha property, which is always important to do with fading animations. And then we're done, and then we start the animation. So life is good unless that view got scrolled off the screen after the animation started, in which case the view has been reassigned to different content and we get that disruptive experience that we saw earlier. So the two workarounds for it are to use a view property animator. So if you check that box at the top of this demo, then instead of using object animator to animate that view, we're going to use view property animator. And we do that by calling code much like this. We say view.animate, that returns the instance of the view property animator for that specific view. Set duration, again, we want an unusually long duration for this animation just for the purposes of this demo. And then we're going to animate alpha to a value of 0 from its current value, which happens to be 1. And when this animation finishes, it's going to have an end action, which does something remarkably similar to what we saw before. It's going to remove the item from the cheese list, notify dataset changed, and restore the alpha property. And we're done. No special magic to work around this. Instead, internally, we're doing the right thing to tell the list view, don't recycle this view yet because I am in the middle of using it. And then when that animation is done, it unsets that flag and that view can be recycled appropriately. The alternate way to do it, if you're not using view property animator, you can have access to this exact same functionality by calling set has transient state. So if you check that other box at the top of the demo that said transient state, then we will say set has transient state. So when you click on the item, we're automatically going to flag that item in the list view as having transient state, which means the list view will not recycle that item until you tell it it's okay. So we're going to set has transient state. We're going to run the same exact animation as before, but on animation end is going to run this little additional bit of code, which restores the transient state to its default state of false. So you click on the item, we start running the object animator, it's fading out the view, it's all happy, you've set transient state on it, we fling the list, that view still exists. Even though it's now off screen, you can't see it anymore, it's not being used for other content, which is really the key to making this animation actually work correctly. So list view animations, if you want to do them right, be aware of that transient state and don't try to animate stuff that's going to be recycled with other content. Thanks.